In his response to the ban imposed on him by Prime Minister Robin Anabanja against further access to health facilities, the Leader of Opposition, Mathias Mpuuga, noted that he does not need the approval or directive of the Prime Minister to carry out his oversight work.
We shouldn't allow people who are looking for political favors.
The Prime Minister, I don't need her approval, tacit or direct, to do anything. She must really try to concentrate. And you see, her lack of concentration, what took her to really go into Mavati, into what? Just concentrate, you know? And I wish the people around her can assist her to understand the extent of her work, so that they don't scatter her into going into the kind of things that doesn't touch.
On her impromptu visit to Kawolo Hospital in Buikwe District recently, Nabanja expressed displeasure with an ongoing oversight tour by Mpuuga, saying it risks inciting civil servants. She expressed disappointment with the medical workers' strike over delayed salaries, which she blamed on Mpuuga, who visited the facility only last week.
Politicize over the lives of Ugandans must stop throughout the country. Not only here, but throughout the country.
She's a good woman. With basic skills of life. Yeah, I can understand her frustration. What I can tell her is that there's time she can follow us. She went to Kawolo, she can be following us.
According to Mpuuga, Nabanja is just struggling to be relevant, in his own words.
It's very difficult, and I can see her struggles at relevancy, and I'm sympathetic.
The Leader of Opposition said he will continue with his oversight duties in different parts of the country. He assured the Prime Minister that he will visit her area in Kakumiro. Mpuuga vowed to leave no stone unturned during the second leg of the opposition tour scheduled to take place in Greater Mpiji District.
I ask of her company to Kakumiro. If she, I know she has a lot of time. She has a lot of time. We shall be in Kakumiro together. She can benefit from my ordinary skills to learn a few things here and there. Maybe she'll survive the DPP. Let her be busy. Otherwise, she knows where she's supposed to be if this was a serious government.
Mpuuga questioned the legality of the Prime Minister's orders, saying they are just populist with no legal basis.
Maybe if she has time, she can come along with me and learn a few things on how to work, and probably learn how governments can work. Maybe it was an admission on her part of the kind of heavy lifting on her shoulders, and I can sympathize.
The Leader of Opposition also shared his discoveries from the one-week oversight tour visit in Greater Luwero and Greater Mukono, including ghost interns in public health facilities.
No facilities. The maternity ward is as congested as they come. You saw us in Kawolo Hospital. Staff not paid for 3 months. They lack the basic lab equipment. Every health center four at least must have the basics, a general lab.
Article 82A of the Constitution empowers the office of the Leader of Opposition to keep the government in check and hold it accountable. The same mandate is also highlighted by Section 6E of the Administration of Parliament Amendment Act 2006. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.